Hey, what's up, guys? This is just a quick video on sidechaining, which is everyone's not-so-secret tool. So you might know sidechaining as just part of a compressor, and that's basically what this is. Inside Bitwig, it's called dynamics. But first, let's have a listen to this track without any sidechain compression on it whatsoever. Okay, right off the bat, you can tell that it's definitely in need of some sidechain compression, and you can achieve that simply by loading up the dynamics. You can find that, click plus, click Bitwig, and it's not the compressor, that's just a straight up compressor, although I suppose you could turn that into the sidechain compressor. This one's called dynamics, and when you load it up, it looks just like this. I've set this up in an unconventional way, and let's have a listen. Okay, so you'll notice that in these regions here, not only is it opening the sidechain to allow the signal to pass through, it's actually amplifying it, and it's doing it in a way that kind of adds a little bit of a shuffle to the pad, which I think is pretty groovy, but that's up to you. If you're here, I think you already know what a sidechain is and how to use it. And so I'm not going to go into this one too much because this just isn't as fun as some of the stuff we're going to do over here. Okay. But basically the take home from this is that if you want typical sidechain, it's called dynamics, and there's all your typical controls, and you can set that up how you like it. But in Bitwig, we can do things a little bit different. This is just the tool that I've loaded up. Okay. And I've clicked a plus in these boxes here and loaded up audio sidechain, and that's what you get. If you click the arrow, these are the settings to the sidechain, so you'll have to go and select the appropriate location for your kick. See if I can undo that. And that's basically that. You have your attack, release, typical stuff. Okay, I put the tool on every track because in Bitwig, you can just click the amplitude knob, click down on the automation lane, and you can go and draw in your automation to change the volume throughout your track. And then what that does is changes the volume of the track to how you want to hear it, but doesn't take away the functionality of the channel fader. But you didn't come all the way out here for workflow techniques. You came here for sidechain compression. So in this case, we're going to use the tool and we're going to exploit the amplitude, which is, for all intents and purposes, your volume. So now we've loaded up the sidechain, the audio sidechain, into one of these, I forget what they're called, I guess macros. And we're going to use it by clicking this and dragging down the amplitude. You know what? Let me create it again. Delete that. Click the plus. Find the tool right there. Click this little arrow, click the plus to add in an effect of some sort, and click audio sidechain. Okay, and that principle is going to apply to any effect that you can load in Bitwig. And I mean anything, even external plugins will have these square plus boxes that you can add a sidechain to. We open up the settings, quickly just choose, where are we here? Quickly choose the kick drum, and now that's fine, you've got it loaded up, but it's not modulating anything, so you need to click the modulator button and choose what you want to modify. In this case, we're just going to make it so every time the kick drum hits, it turns down the amplitude. Now, one thing you'll notice, if we have a listen quick, you can already see right here that piece of frequency is basically constant throughout the entire song, and we don't want to measure that, so we set the margins of the sidechain to ignore it. So now it's only concerning itself with what's inside here and ignoring what's inside there. So let's have a listen. See, we're starting to get a classic sidechain feel. And of course, you could do that with the panning, the width, and you know what? In a lot of cases, sorry, turn that off, crank the width up, and then crank it all the way down. So not only is it gonna turn down the overall volume of the pad, it's gonna take it and make it completely mono. Let's have a listen. Okay, so that principle of loading an audio sidechain to any effect in Bitwig is fantastic, and I think you know what's coming next. Let's open up a filter here. In the effort of sidechaining, most of the time we're trying to lower the volume of the pad so that the kick drum can poke through. Well, not only is it volume that we're concerned with, but more specifically, it's the low frequencies that conflict with the bass drum that we want to remove. So in this instance, we've loaded up an audio sidechain, and not only are we going to turn down the overall volume of that channel, of the pad channel, we're also going to bring up a high pass filter and effectively duck any of the low frequencies that the kick drum might be having. Let me open up these settings and let's have a listen. So right off the bat, you'll notice it's not as dramatic of an effect, but what it's doing is allowing the kick to still poke through while maintaining the majority of the volume of your pad, which might be helpful in many instances where you like the sound of your pad, but you don't like how your kick drum just gets buried inside it, okay? And that's basically the same principle. I just click this and I turn that up and that down, okay? But who would we be if we didn't exploit Bitwig a little bit further and get a little bit crazy? If we don't explore, then really we've just stayed home, and that's no fun. So check this out. I figure, being the clear thinking individual that I am at most times, what kind of things lower the volume of a track? Well, reverb sort of does. It kind of creates the illusion that it is anyway. So if I have this on maximum reverb, it'll sound quieter than if I don't have any reverb on it at all in many cases. Not only that, the diffusion, right? Because it kind of scatters the sound. I also have a chorus here that is set to vibrato. And so basically every time, see, I've added a chain. Inside the chain are these following effects. And now I've added an audio sidechain to the chain. So now if I click this, you'll see that every time the kick drum hits, it turns up the mix on the chain, which means it's putting full signal through this reverb, which is at full mix, full diffusion, which means it's scattering my sound all over the place every time the kick drum hits. Furthermore, I'm turning up the speed on my vibrato and the mix, okay? And even further, I have it going from very wide to very mono, very narrow, and turning down the amplitude a little bit. And you can just go crazy. You can add anything you want in here and affect it, okay? And that's just me thinking about the things that reduce volume and remove frequencies from the low end where the kick drum wants to exist. And you can do that. You can set that up in any way that you want. I'm not sure that this one's actually going to be that good sound, that great of a sound in this case. But it serves the purpose of telling you that you're not limited to just a compressor sidechain. You can do virtually anything that you want, even outboard. Or sorry, not outboard, plugins that you bought that are third party to Bitwig will have this little thing here, and you can just add an audio sidechain to anything, okay? So before I hit play and show you what this is, I just want to remind you, please subscribe, like, comment. If you have any comments or questions, definitely leave them below. You can email me too, and I'd love to hear from you. If you come up some crazy effects chains, put the link or put a description of it down below and share it with the community. We'd love to hear it. Okay, let's have a listen. You know what's cool? Is every time the kick drum hits and all these effects kick in, it kind of creates a click on this track, which for all intents and purposes is actually a problem. But in the case of a kick drum, you want a little bit of a click to happen just before the drum strikes. And that's kind of neat. It adds a little bit of a click to the kick drum where once it didn't exist. Let's hear this solo. Pretty groovy. All right, let me know what you find. Take care.